Hey, how you doing?
I'm well. How are you?
Doing good. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Lanera Washington, thank you for joining me on the Chris Gunther Show.
Of course.
How's everything going for you out there?
Pretty good. We're staying home, trying
Yeah.
to be good.
Yeah, like trying to maintain, I guess, what's called social distancing, but we're all kind of anxious to get back out there.
There's definitely some, especially with a little one, and she's an only child. There's this
Yes.
urge to want to see other little people. I could do this all. I have to say, I'm kind of a homebody, so I enjoy being at home. But definitely, when you have, a child, you want them to experience the world as much as they can, and it's hard when we're on lockdown.
Is like I feel like this is the worst punishment I've ever been on, and I wasn't even a bad kid growing up.
You know what? I take a spanking at this point.
It's like, for some people that, were always on punishment, this is nothing new to them. But for those of us like myself, we don't like just being in a house all day. Like, this is just wrong, I tell you. It's wrong.
Right.
But
Yes.
it's really good to hear from you. You are actually on the Urban Flicks TV show Casting the Net, correct?
Correct. Yes.
How much fun is it to be a part of that?
It was a ton of fun, mostly because we had such a great cast. I mean, cast, crew, everybody who was involved. We just had fun on set all the time, so it didn't even really feel like work, and
How
that's
did
really
you
the
even
best.
like? I am so sorry.
Oh, no. Those are the best situations when you go to work and it doesn't feel like you're working. And you're really enjoying what you're doing. Those are always the best situations.
When you got contacted for the role, like how excited were you once they told you what the show was going to be about and who are your castmates?
Well, I have to say, the writer of the show is my husband, and he wrote the show based on experiences that I myself have had, be it on set or going to auditions as an actor. And he sort of took life experiences from other friends of mine and other people that we know, and created the story. So I had kind of like an inside, scoop into it. So he wrote the part specifically for me, which is lovely and wonderful. Even though, there are some differences. Obviously, I'm not divorced. I'm not a single
Yes.
mom. But
Do you feel that because your husband wrote it, that it really fit to like your best attributes as an actress?
A lot of it, yes. I mean, he knows me pretty well. He knows my strengths. He knows my weaknesses. He knows where to challenge me and what buttons to push.
Yes.
So definitely, I think he captured a fair amount of my essence. But I also think that there's enough in there that is different from me that it gives me as an actor the challenge to sort of rise the occasion, because you don't want to just play yourself.
Yes. It seems like there's a lot of fun with the cast and even with the people that like you actually work with. As somebody that's been in this business for a very long time, how much of a rare commodity is that you actually get a chance to act alongside people that you actually like and that you actually enjoy working with?
It really just it depends. I think everyone sort of comes with their own kind of energy, and it's just sometimes a matter of how energies mesh, and less about whether or not people really like each other. I've lucked out a lot in this business, especially when my husband and I are working together producing something. We are very intentional about the kind of people we want to draw into our projects, and
Yes.
so even though I wasn't a producer on this one, I was very much involved in, sitting and doing auditions and participating and sort of getting a feel for the people who were coming in. And so I think we just really did a good job of finding those, making that puzzle piece, those puzzle pieces sort of come together. And I feel really blessed to be working with Sienna Gonnet and April Jones. They are a riot. They are funny, but more
Yes.
importantly, they're just really kind of chill, nice, decent people, so it made it really easy.
I had Sienna on my show last week and she had me cracking up.
Oh, she is a mess, that one. Oh my gosh, I love her so much. She
Yeah,
is
like she had me
ridiculous.
cracking up and like I was asking her things like how can people like follow you, connect with you? And she was kind of like, what do you mean by that? And I
Right.
was laughing so hard because I knew good and well she didn't really know what I was talking about. So I kind of had to break it down to her. And both of us are pretty light skinned, so both of us was turning red, and I thought that was pretty cool. So it's, I mean, hey, shout out to her. If she sees this, you know, it's nothing but love here. And, you know, like, how much fun is it to even work with her in April? Because on the show, you guys are close, but off the show, like, I know things like that don't just happen overnight. So how is it working with them?
It was really great. Honestly, I think we clicked really quickly. And I don't know if it's just that we came to this as three women who've been working in the business for some time. So we not only understand the dynamics of the business at large, but how it also played into our characters in the script. But also, again, just people who enjoy the work. We enjoy the work. So we show up to work happy to be there. And then on top of that, as individuals, I think we're all kind of quirky. We're all a little funny. We're a little crazy. Which
just a little bit.
You kind of need in this business a little bit of craziness to keep you going. And so we always had a good time. I don't know. It was pretty easy. They're pretty easy people to like.
Yes.
And I hope I'm a pretty easy person to like. I try not to, you know, I'm just me. You know, we show up and we're real. I think that's more than anything. We are who we are. And there's no questioning it. So I think that helps too.
Your character in the show is somebody that, you know, as I got a chance to catch up on it a little bit, I was looking and I was curious, is that how you really are in real life, or is that strictly for urban flicks?
How I am in real life, as far as Cassie, and like what specifically?
Like, is there anything that your character does that you look at and be like, wow, like that's actually me in real life? Like, are there any attributes that Cassie has you have in real life?
Oh yeah, I'm definitely a little neurotic. I'm a person who has had to really work on not worrying. I worry a lot about what other people think.
Yes.
And I think Cassie definitely is a character who worries a lot. She wants to be proper. She wants to do it the right way. She wants to always sort of give the appearance of everything's okay and everything's great, even when it's not.
yes.
I think Cassie's a loyal character. I'd say I'm a pretty loyal person. I really, you know, love my people. And when you're like in my circle, you are in your family, you are in my circle. But yes. I also think that, I think maybe like Cassie, sometimes I forget to see the glass half full.
Mm-hmm.
I think sometimes she is a glass half empty person.
Yes.
And I too have to remind myself that I am so blessed and so lucky and really privileged to do the work that I get to do. And that the pursuit of that same pursuit that Cassie's on to sort of get that big project, you know, there's that, but it's not just getting there. It is the journey. It is the
yes.
thing that we do in between. It is the people that you meet. It's those times that you get off of the path to do something different and new that really ignite your life. And I think she and I have those kinds of things in common.
You have been blessed to be in this business for quite some time now. What made you even decide to become an actress?
I knew I wanted to be an actress probably from the minute I took my first breath. I have always enjoyed be it theater, film, stuff like that. I've always been obsessed with it. So I knew at a very young age that this is what I wanted to do. My parents, on the other hand, really pushed me towards the math and sciences because I was really good at math and science. And so
yes.
for the longest, I aspired to be a doctor. But once I hit college and sort of started doing it and realized
yes.
that my dream of, or what I thought was my dream of being a pediatric oncologist meant that babies die. And I had to sort of come to that reality that like,
yeah.
you're a pediatric oncologist, you're going to deal with a lot of children who are sick and possibly dying. No, I sort of came to that conclusion that was not going to sit well with me. And I think I just always knew. I always knew that I wanted to be performing. And so when I really committed to it, it kind of just took off.
What's the feeling you get when you're performing?
Wow, that's a great question. You know, when I'm really in it, when I know that I've like hit that groove, it's almost like I don't even realize I'm acting. Do you ever get that feeling kind of like you're floating? You're floating, but you're grounded. It's sort of a weird mix.
It is.
You're so in it that you feel so connected. It feels so real. You almost forget that you are you and that you are just playing a character.
Yeah. Like, yeah. Even though I'm not an actor, I can kind of see where you're going with that, though. Yes.
Right. Yeah. You know, you get kind of tingly, kind of like heavy, but light at the same time. I don't know. It's a real mix of sort of yin and yang. It's almost like you're right in the perfect, you were standing on a needle.
Yes.
And you're right on top at the perfect balance. And the needle's not poking you, but at the same time, you're aware that it's there and it's keeping you afloat. And yeah, I don't know. It's just the best feeling. I love it. I love being on set. I love the smell of a set. I love the sounds on the set, the energy that you get from like the past ghosts of shows that were there.
Yeah.
All of it.
You said the past ghosts of shows. What kind of shows have you been on that the people would be like, oh, snap? Because I remember you being on Criminal Minds. I believe you were also on a few more, like, serious shows. I believe, I want to say, not Numbers, but I know it was somewhere around
right.
There.
I've done CSI, NCIS.
That was it. That's what I was trying to think of, that one. Correct.
Grey's Anatomy was kind of a big one. That was a real sort of tearjerker episode that people kind of remember when I talk about it. It was the Code Pink episode where I have a C-section in the hallway and the hospital's locked down.
How do you even prepare to do a role like that?
You know, a lot of it is about listening to your fellow characters, understanding the context of, you know, what was happening, what got her to that moment. This was a mom, which at that point I'd already had a child, so I understood all of that sort of excitement and energy that goes into giving birth to a child. But you know, my character had been in a car accident, and you just sort of have to sort of put yourself in that place of what are the kind of feelings I would be feeling. Again, what might I smell in the midst of a car accident, especially a massive car accident? What are the things that I would be thinking about? What would I be worried about? She was in that car accident with her children. And as a mother, your children are like, I mean, you know, any good mom that will tell you, your children are everything. So like, what,
yes,
you know, and then it's about listening to your characters, understanding what's going on in the scene, understanding what you're saying, but also what's happening in between the lines that you're saying. What are those emotions and things that we're not necessarily outright expressing, and how can I go about expressing those without saying them? It's just about making connections and you know, really finding how you relate to the other people in the scene.
Speaking about making connections, what is it about the characters on that show that you felt connected you to those roles?
On which show specifically? On
shows such as your Grey's Anatomies and your CSIs, or mm-hmm. even on shows now that you're doing, like such as Casting the Net.
Well, you know, again, I think there is an aspect of, especially when you're talking about like procedurals, those hour-long shows, there are certain themes that are sort of carried on throughout various types of shows. So like, you know, CSIs, the NCISs, they all have a similar energy about them. And I think sometimes when it came to those kinds of parts, my characters, I'm often cast as the sweet, the nice neighbor, the good, helpful best friend. And there are essences about those characters that really match my own natural essence.
Yes.
And so you find a connection with my character that then I can extrapolate that to like connect with the different people I have to work with, depending on what their role is, you know?
Yes.
So, you know, on NCIS, I was playing the nanny, and he was, you know, the head of the task force. And so he had a certain position. I had to sort of understand who he was in order to be able to, you know, relate to him and really understand where he was coming from as a man who had lost his wife.
Yes.
Who needed someone to care for his children. And so all those things sort of come into play, and you kind of just make the best choice you can. And hopefully you make a choice that really resonates with people. You know, I did a movie, Killing Them Softly, for instance, which sort of took me out of my, I said, safety zone of character types.
Yes.
And I played a prostitute.
I was going to ask you about that next. So that's crazy.
You know, that's not my regular kind of work. It's not the kind of part that I think people usually associate with me, but associate, you know, Lenato Washington with. So it was really kind of fun to get out of that comfort zone and have to think about, okay, so how do I play a character who's really not someone that I, in my day-to-day life, would come across, or in my day-to-day life sort of would interact with, or have an, you know, who you would offhand not think you have similarities with.
Yes.
And, but it's my job to sort of find that connection, you know, find the connection to this character. And, you know, she was a woman who was taking charge of her life. You know, you got to kind of find the connections, taking charge of her life, making certain decisions about what she wanted and how she wanted to feel powerful. She wanted to feel, you know, in control.
Yes.
So you take those kinds of, that kind of energy and you know, you got to play with it.
Yes. You got to play with it. You know, you have to figure out which one can you do, which one do you say I need to practice up or sharpen up my skills more on so I can perfect it. Which movie did you really enjoy being a part of?
Oh, wow. There have been a couple.
Because, you know, you have a very nice, you know, like, list, but if you could choose one that you really enjoyed the most, which one do you think that would be?
You know, I would have to probably say I really enjoyed, now, you know, I really enjoyed Kings of the Evening. I did Kings of the Evening probably going on 12 years now. It was probably one of my first lead roles in a feature film.
Yes.
And I just got to work with some really amazing people. I mean, I got to work opposite Tyson Beckford, and that alone was, you know, was really cool. Lynn Whitfield.
Yes.
A big fan of hers my whole life growing up. So to be able to work opposite her was a dream. And then, of course, Glenn Turman, another amazing heavy hitter. It was a really beautiful experience. And I think that was one of those roles that I just really, like, dug into. I loved that it was a period piece. I loved the era. I loved the clothing, the hair, everything about, you know, the outside aspects of my character that I got to sort of pull together and sort of feel like a whole person. Probably one of the best experiences in that regard, being able to pull, like, okay, this is what her hair would look like, and these are the clothes she would wear, and this is the time that she's living in, and this is her story. And I loved it. Loved every minute of it.
You loved every minute of it. And I could tell just by, you know, you expressing how it was nice to even wear clothes like that or hair like that. Do you feel that maybe you were born in the wrong time frame?
Yes and no. There are aspects definitely of certain eras when it comes to, I don't know, just people used to put on beautiful hats to walk out the door, you know?
Yes.
Women used to wear gloves and just even just those lovely dresses with corsets and things. I love, you know, the regalia of all that and sort of the energy put into that. As far as the time itself, I don't know that I'd want to live in, you know, 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, I mean, sometimes even 2020 is feeling really hard.
So, it is.
Yeah, you know, clearly certain eras have their challenges. But no, I think as far as when you talk about stylistically how people dress and how people carry themselves, there are aspects of some of those eras that I just absolutely love.
As far as the eras of movies, which one do you feel for you was the best?
Eras for movies that were the best. You know, I'm an 80s child. Not to give away my age. But I don't know. There's just something about the 80s. You know, 80s into 90s, that early part of the 90s. There were just some really great movies. I mean, music was good. I don't know. I'd say that late 80s into early 90s period of stuff was great. You know, we just introduced our daughter to, like, Back to the Future and Harry and the Hendersons, Gremlins. You know, they just don't make them like that anymore.
This is very true. They definitely don't. Like, if you had to choose maybe your top three actresses that inspired you to act, who would they be?
Oh, my goodness.
And you can only pick three.
I can only pick three.
Only three. Your top three. Who would you say that, like, okay, this person really inspired me. This one really inspired me, but this is the one I really wanted to be like. So if you could pick three, who would they be?
Well, people are going to laugh at me. I'm a huge Emma Thompson fan, and part of that goes back to her versatility as an actor. You know, she's British. She does all the corset movies, but then she'll turn around and do a film where she's speaking in a perfect American accent.
Yes.
And I just find her, she's funny. she's goofy but attractive in her own little way. You know, she's kind of like a full package kind of actor. You can throw her into any sort of circumstance and she will create brilliance out of it. I think that's what I've always really appreciated about her work. You know, Meryl Streep, I think, is kind of an easy one to choose, but I pick her just because, again, she's one of those actresses who can do any accent you throw her way. I think if there was something I would probably work on more,
yes,
that ability. I mean, she can literally throw any character from any country at you, I'm sure, and nail it. You gotta love Angela Bassett.
Love Queen Angie.
I mean, strong, black, confident, beautiful. Everything from Shakespeare to, you know, Down Dirty Hood, whatever.
Yeah.
She's just amazing. And she just has, I mean, you know, black don't crack. She's going to be around forever.
Not at all. I love black women. That's why I'm marrying one, for crying out loud. You know, that's how it's supposed to be. Right. So, you know, this has definitely been fun. I greatly appreciate you for taking this time out. How can people learn more about you and how can they catch you on Casting the Net?
Great. Well, Casting the Net can be found on Urban Flix TV. On your TV, you can check it out through Apple TV, Roku, Chromecast, Fire Stick. Otherwise, if you want to watch on your computer or your phone, you can go to urbanflixtv.com. The first 7 days of your membership is free. It's $4.99 a month. It's totally worth it. Not only can you watch Casting the Net, but there are a lot of great other original shows that they have there.
Yes.
Movies, things. So you'll after you binge watch my wonderful show, you can check out some of the other ones. And then you can check out LenataWashington.com. That's my website. I'm on Facebook as Lenata Washington. I'm on Insta as Lenata Washington as well. So I love to follow people. I love interesting, fun people. So come find me.
Absolutely. Well, nothing else needs to be asked. Ms. Washington, thank you so much for joining us. Be sure that you guys like and share this video. Lenata Washington, ladies and gentlemen, on the Chris Gunner Show. Thank y'all for watching. I'll see y'all next time.
Thank you so much.